Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb. And Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ear, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her for 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. So today, you know, one of the beautiful things about the Solemnities that we celebrate in the Catholic Church is it gave us an opportunity to reflect on the deeper meaning of that Solemnity. So we have all the readings, so the priest has some freedom. He could focus on the readings for the day, or he could focus on the dogma or the doctrine, or what is the relevance of that Solemnity for us as people of God. And so today, I am going to do the latter. So today we celebrate the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary into heavenly glory. You know, the Catholic Church, our church, teaches as dogma that the Virgin Mary, having completed her earthly life, was assumed body and soul into heavenly glory. This dogma was defined and proclaimed by Pope Pius XII. There are several Piuses. This one is Pius the what? 12. And he proclaimed this on November 1st, 1950. So now back in the day. And the document that he used to proclaim that is called the Apostolic Constitution. And in Latin is called Magnificentissimus Deus, the Magnificent God. You know, it's that word, Magnificentissimus Deus, the Magnificent God who is able to do all things possible. But to understand this Solemnity, you know, there's another Solemnity that gives us a better understanding of why we celebrate this. Who want to guess the other Solemnity? It's in December. It's on December 8th. What is it called? It starts with I, C. Immaculate Conception. So the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary helps us to understand what we celebrate in the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. But you say, "Well, Father, how does that help us to understand?" And that's what I'm about to do right now to tell you. So almost a century before the proclamation of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to be precise, about 96 years before this Solemnity we celebrate was proclaimed, another pope, he was called Pius IX, So he's another pious. Now the assumption was proclaimed by pious the what? 12. The Immaculate Conception dogma was proclaimed by Pius the Ninth. And Pius the Ninth, you know, in his own apostolic constitution. So that's the, when this is a lot of teachings going on. Whenever there is a dogma to be proclaimed, because you are in higher education, so it's important for me to explain that. It is always proclaimed in an apostolic constitution. Because the constitution is the highest law that governs an institution, a country, the church, stuff like that. So in that apostolic constitution, ineffabilis Deus, the ineffable God. You know, they like this. It's, I love it. You love it too, Betoya? It's very good. On December 8th, the Pope stated that we declare, pronounce, and define that the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception, which holds that the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, in the first instance of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege granted by the Almighty God, and in view of the merits of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the human race, that Mary was preserved free from every stain of original sin, is a doctrine revealed by God, and therefore to be believed firmly and constantly by all the faithful. In other words, the Immaculate Conception dogma and Solemnity exempts the Blessed Virgin Mary from the human conditions of original sin in order for her to be the purest vessel to give birth to the Son of God. You see that? Now, because of that status, you know, it serves as a foundation for this solemnity that we are celebrating, the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Because in this Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, guess what is happening? Mary is taken up into heavenly glory in her incorruptible body and soul, which was protected and sustained by the Immaculate Conception. You see the connection there? Good. So that the Blessed Virgin Mary will be reunited with her Son Jesus Christ, because she brought him into the world. So there's the whole thing of being reunited, you know, that is coming out here. Who himself, in his ascension into heaven, was, he ascended into heaven in glory, and he is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. So therefore, this Solemnity is a day of great joy. So already in the gospel reading, you see Mary going to greet Elizabeth. So there's a sense of being reunited with family. There's a sense of that joy, you know, and that is why this Mass today is live streamed, because it is a joy for us to celebrate this Mass, you know, with our new director for the Bowman Scholar Program, my assistant Rudy, you know, my niece Margaret, you know, and with all of you, Betoya, Chuku, and the family, you know, who are here, you know, for us to celebrate and be reunited. You know, it is a joy too, because we are anticipating the students coming back to school. There's a whole reunification, you know, to overcome, override, you know, the hindrance of the pandemic that prevented us from being together. You see that? So it's very important for us, and it's relevant for us now. So it is a day of joy for all of us Catholics. It is a day of joy for families. It is a day of joy for friends of God. And it is a day of joy for student disciples and missionary disciples. So that is why we celebrate this day, connecting it with our own joy. It's a day of joy because it shows the power of love and being reunited with the ones we love. This week, you know, and next week, we will be reuniting our students. It is special for us that you return to collegiate life and the universities. And we are looking forward to accompanying you and each of them on the journey. Like I said, I just returned this morning, you know, and it helped me to be reunited with Margaret, because I was missing Margaret. She herself was missing me. I was missing her. I said, look, my little, my bogies, come here, bogies.
You know, so you miss people who you are close to. You know, you miss your children. You know, so this assumption of the Blessed Mother reunites her with Jesus in heaven in glory. And that is a powerful reality, you know, that we miss people we love. And being reunited with one another is important in the Christian life. The assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary also shows us that power of love. You know, it teaches us that love has won, and God has won. Because God himself is love, love has won. It has won life. So love has shown that in its strongest term, love is stronger than death. Life is stronger than death. That God possesses the true strength, and that his strength is the goodness and love. As we celebrate this Solemnity, my dear students, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ, we are assured that we also have a mother in heaven. And the mother of the Son of God is our mother, because Jesus himself has said so. He told the disciples on the cross, he said, "Women, behold your son." He said, "Behold your mother." So we have a mother in heaven. Our mother who is in heaven on this Solemnity is celebrating with us and has also opened for us the glory of God as we make our journey. May God bless you beyond measure. May God be with us as we reunite with each other. And whenever we have the opportunity to be together, we want to thank God for that reunification. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.